is a papyrus plant. It's an aquatic undertone. Oh, excuse me. Here is the two bankers of the river Nile. Also, the ancient Egyptians considered it holy plant for two main reasons. The first one, the flower, looks like sun rays, symbol of Amun-Ra, god of sun in the ancient time. The second reason, the end of this plant looks like Ramche, symbol of eternity, of eternal life. Cut it according to the size of pictures. For example, if we want a big one like that, we cut it in sizes. Yes, yes, it's very long length, so for example, it will be about 4 or 5 meters high, but this one is a normal one, about 1 meter or half meter. Yes. If we want a big one like that, we cut it to big sizes, medium one like that one, so we cut it to medium sizes. Small one like the other one over there, we cut it to small one. For example, like that one. After that, we remove the green cover, like that one.
Oh, I see.
Yes, like this one. Like this one. We see the green cover very strong, as you see. So the ancient Egyptians used it to make different things, like caps, boots, sandalwoods, baskets, yes. But this one is not important. The most important one is that one, the inner white part, because we use it to make all the stuff, all the papers that we have here. We see this part breakable, as you see, because it has too much water and it many percent of sugar. To make very simple paper like all we have here, we have to reduce both of them, water and sugar. First, use hammer like that way to reduce the first one of water, excuse me, and after that, use rolling pin to make it stronger and more flexible. Now we see that one is stronger, more flexible than before because we already have reduced the first one of water. But also we have to reduce the other one of sugar. So put it in that water to reduce the other amount of sugar from 20 to 10% of sugar. If we want a little paper like that one, we put the slices in the water for 6 days and we exchange water every day. But to get the brown color like the other one over there, we put the slices here in the water but for 12 days without exchange the water. After that, we take the slices off from the water and put all of them between two pieces of carpets exactly like these two in horizontal and vertical line. First, we do the slices one beside one from the right. Yes, and after that, we put the others one beside one, but from up to down, exactly as you see. And after that, we put the other piece and we put both of them under modern press. Like that for 6 days more to get in paper, or for 12 days under the same press to get the brown one. And they stick together when we put all of them under the press for 1 week together with the paper, or for 2 weeks to get the brown one. Yes, after 6 days under the press, we get a paper exactly like this one, very strong and also very flexible. You can run it easily like that way. And if we put it under light, with these slices into directions, horizontal or vertical, and vertical, in that case, we make sure that this one is the original papyrus paper made of papyrus plant, more like the fake ones that other people sell in the street around the Egyptian Museum grounds area, because the other one is the fake one made of banana leaves and sugar cane. And if you put it under light, you will see just one direction, horizontal or vertical, not the two together like the original piece. This is the difference between both original or fake one. When we get all the papers, yellow or brown, we send all of them to the Faculty of Fine Arts here in Egypt to be painted by the hands of our